I just got home from a run to find the seeds I ordered online waiting for me in the mailbox, which gave me the idea to try a series following planting from seed all the way to tasting that first fruit. I had never successfully ordered seeds from a small online retailer. I've only ever ordered them from the big places, so I wasn't sure what to expect, and I was pleasantly surprised. It's very simple, yet professional packaging. Nice little paper towel, keep it cheap, but protect the seeds. And then these two little envelopes full of seeds. As you can see, I ordered the Casper eggplant. I grew this last year. It was incredibly prolific. It's a white eggplant. It's supposed to taste like a mushroom. I grew dozens of them, but I have no idea what they taste like because the rats ate every single one of them. By the time we got the rats taken care of, I had totally lost interest and I lost the plant completely to spider mites. It just was not worth saving. And the other seeds that I have not tasted these before. These are Jimmy Nardello sweet pepper seeds. Everything that I have read about these online says that they are full-on candy-style sweet. Literally, they taste like taffy. I have no idea. I'm really skeptical, but really curious. I cannot wait to taste these. I find the simple yet effective packaging really impressive, so I'm going to go ahead and give a plug to the retailer. It is Harley Store on Etsy. I will put a link in the description, and I'll probably even put one right here, just in case you need some seeds. They have a large selection. These are just the two that I was most looking forward to this year, and they happened to both be available. I don't really have room for these, but I want them so much that I'm gonna go ahead and go for it. I'm going to start with the Casper eggplant. As you can see on the label, it is recommended that they be direct sown, but I don't have anywhere to direct sow them because I'm already out of space in my garden. I will be making more containers in a future episode, hopefully to line up with these sprouting. I will be planting about, let's see, 5 seeds will do. Spread those out. If they all grow, I will have to thin them. But just to be on the safe side, because it's getting late in the season, we'll start with 5. Brush them over. Now we will do the Jimmy Nardello. I did try to grow the Jimmy Nardello last year, but I didn't put much effort into it. I ordered a plant online because it seemed impressive, but then I didn't put it in a proper container. Didn't have one of my moisture wicking containers, but I still watered it on the same schedule as the moisture wicking containers, which led to it drying out rather quickly and dying. So don't do that. Especially if you're buying plants online. So they're expensive, and you're paying for shipping. And yeah, it's not good to waste money. It's wasteful. That was a joke. Of course it's wasteful. There we go. There's our 5 seeds. Poke them down. Again, we're just doing 5 to be on the safe side. Once they start growing and we have somewhere to put them, like a larger planter, then we'll thin them out. Now we will take these outside, we'll water them, and we'll put them in a nice sunny spot. And hopefully in 14 days, we will have some nice eggplant and pepper sprouts. Now we are outside in the seed starting area of the balcony. Yes, that's right in the middle of the balcony. It gets a nice amount of sunlight, and since the plants are in the way, I don't forget to water them. Up here are some greens that I'm going to grow in a future episode and try something fancy with those. These are some watermelon, early moonbeam watermelon to be precise. Those are going to take the place of some of the dying tomatoes. And then up here we have features of this episode, the Jimmy Nardello pepper and the Casper eggplant. Now all I gotta do is water these in and we will be started. I'm going to be using my homemade watering can. Yes, very fancy. It is a cat litter jug that I burned some holes into the top. I didn't need to buy a real watering can because most of my containers are moisture wicking containers, which means I water them from the bottom. So a watering can is not important. And that should do it. I will see you in 14 days, and hopefully I will be showing you some cool video of my pepper and eggplant sprouts. That should do it. I'll see you next time upstairs in the garden.